Hello students, this is the 12th video of our first module, and in this video I'm going to explain you about the declaration of variables and assigning values for those variables. So till now we are clear with what exactly is a variable and what are the different data types we have. So once we are clear with the variables and the data types, we are going to declare the data variables based on the data types. So what data value you want to store, based on that you are going to declare a variable. So coming to the declaration of variables, variable declaration will do two things. So what are those two things? We will see. It tells the compiler what the variable name is. It tells the compiler to identify the variable name. Then it specifies what type of data the variable will hold. So first the name has to be finalized, and later what type of data this variable has to hold has to be declared. So that is what variable declaration will do two things. That is, it specify two things to the compiler. So first one is what is the name of that variable, and later what type of data this variable will hold. So both these things will be specified to the compiler. Then the declaration of variables must be done before they are used in a program. So before we are going to use any of the variables in our program, we have to declare them first. So declaration of the variables can be done in two different types, that is primary type declaration and user defined type declaration. So primary type declaration means based on the primary data types. What are the primary data types we have? Means integer, float, character. So these are the primary data types which we have. Based on that we are going to declare the variables, or it may be based on the user defined data types. So a user defined type declaration, it will be including the user defined data type values. So first we will move on with the primary type declaration, then we will go on with the user defined type declaration. So here we can find the syntax for this data type followed by the variable names, whatever we have. So v1, v2 till vn are the variable names which are of what data type we have to specify there. So this syntax also can be used in order to declare the variable. So where v1, v2, vn are the names of the variables, variables are separated by commas, and a declaration statement must always, it should end with the semicolon. If we are not going to follow the syntax of our C language, then it will be showing the syntax error in our during the execution part of our program. So once the compiler will start compiling it, if it doesn't find the syntax accordingly, then it is going to display the syntax error. So here are few examples how we are going to declare a variable. Here is one variable with the name count, which is of integer data type. Number and total are the two variables which are of integer data type. Ratio is one variable which is of double data type. So these are the examples of our primary data type declaration. And then coming to the data types and their keywords, we have different data types here. So based on the names like byte, short, int, long, float, double, char and boolean, we have different values which can be used for the description of those particular keywords. Like short, it represents the short int, int represents the integer value, long represents the long integer. Like that only float, double, all the different keywords will be used in order to specify what data type it is, and that variable name also should be declared with that particular data type. So we have an example here which has 3, 5, 6 type of declarations. So, sorry, 7 type of declarations here. X, Y are float data type, code is integer data type, count is short in data type, amount is long in data type, deviation is double data type, and N is unsigned integer data type, and C is character data type. So these, this is one of the example how we are going to declare the variables with different data type values. And these are few numbers or literals which we have, and it specifies what data type it is. 178 means integer value. So integer means unsigned only we will be considering. Unsigned means the maximum range is 0 to 255. So that's why 178, it comes within the range. So it is integer value, valid integer value. So like that we have different literals here, and also what data type it contains. Then coming to one more example, we have int number. Number is a variable which is of integer data type, and we are going to enter an integer number. Whatever number we are going to enter, we have to check whether it is smaller than 100 or greater than 100. So if the number which we are going to enter, if it is below 100, means like 99 and some other number, then it has to print, the program has to print your number is smaller than 100. If we are going to enter a three digit number, then our program has to print the output or give the output as your number contains more than two digits. So whatever number we are going to enter through the keyboard, so based on that we are going to get the printout statement. This is one example. So how the output looks like is, enter an integer number. If I enter 54, your number is smaller than 100 because it is smaller than 100. If I'm going to enter three digit number 108, then it will be showing your number contains more than two digits. So that is about the primary data type declaration. Then coming to the user defined type declaration. So in user defined type declarations, we have two types, type definition and enumerated data types. So type definition means we are going to use a keyword here followed by the type, what primary data type and the name, whatever we are going to specify. So for example, if I give type def int units, means units is one identifier which will be of integer data type from now onwards. Instead of using int, I can make use of this identifier name in order to declare the variables which are of units data type. Units in turn, it is of integer data type. Then similarly, marks is float data type, and these marks, it can be used in order to declare the variables which are of float data type. So this is how we are going to use this type definitions. Next type of user defined type declaration is enumerated data type. So here enum is the keyword which I'm going to use. Identifier name I have to specify, and what are the set of values this identifier will hold, that also can be specified explicitly. Only these values can be set to the variable names which are of this data type. For example, enumerator enum day, Monday, Tuesday till Sunday are the values which I'm going to store for day. And two variables I have declared, day, week start and week end, which are of enumerated data type of day. And week start will be assumed with one of the values of this Monday. Yes, it is valid because it is present in the value list. And week end will be Friday. Yes, that is also present in the valid list. So like that, we can go on, give the values for our identifier, which are of enumerated data type. So this is about user defined data types. Then coming to the storage classes. Storage classes will specify till when our variable will be visible throughout the program. For example, if we are going to declare it as global variable throughout the program, whether it may be a main function or a sub function, so everywhere it will be visible and it can be used. If it is declared as a local variable, it will be used only within that particular part of a program or particular part of a function. So here in this program, it has one global variable m which is declared outside the program, outside the main function. It implies that it will be visible throughout the program, either in main function or in the sub function. But here I, it is declared within the main function and also within the sub function. So it will be visible only in this part. Float balance and float sum are also two local declared variables which can be used only within that particular function. So we have four different storage classes. One is auto, static, external and register. Auto, static and register are for local variable declarations. What changes will happen if we are going to declare them as auto, static and register? We can see that. And extern is representing the global declaration of the variables. So that is what we are going to declare the variables along with the storage classes. This storage classes, again, it will be explained in the fourth module of our CPS subject. Then coming to the assigning values to the variable, how we are going to assign the values. Based on these two statements, we can assign variable name equal to constant. Whatever value you want to assign this variable name with, we can assign the value, or else we are going with the declaration. In the declaration part only, we are going to assign the values. So these are the two types of assignment statements which we have, and examples are also given here. So initial value will be 0, final value will be 100, and balance will be 78.84, s equals to x. These are the four assignment statements which we can have, or else the other type is we are going to declare these variables, final value, yes, and balance. So during the declaration part itself, we can go with the assignment of the constant values for them. So we have one example also here. So float, xp, yq and k. So all these are the variables which are of this following.